Hello friends, let's listen the tale of two snakes. It was told by Prakarkand to Arimardhan.
Hello friends, let's listen the story, the tale of two snakes. There was a king called Devashakti who was very frustrated on his son, who was very lean and weak. He grew leaner and weaker every day. Well-known physicians from far-off places could not cure him, because there was a snake inside his stomach. They tried all sorts of treatments, but in vain. The young prince was also frustrated to see his father sad for him, and he was fed up with his life. One night he crept outside the palace and went to another kingdom. He started living in a temple and ate from whatever alms he collected from kind people. The country was ruled by a king who had two young daughters. They were raised with the best of learning. Every morning they would bow at their father's feet to seek his blessing. One of the daughters said, "O father, all joys of the world is bestowed upon us with your blessings." And the other daughter would say, "O king, one only gets the fruits that are destined for one's actions." The comments of the second daughter made the king very angry, and one day he summoned his ministers. "Let her enjoy the fruits that are destined for her actions. Take her and marry her off to anybody you meet outside the palace." The ministers did so and were unable to find anybody when they saw the young prince who was living in the temple. The two were married. The princess was a religious girl and considered her husband as her god. She was very happy and content with the marriage. They decided to travel to a different part of the country, as it would be improper for them to make the temple as their home. On the way, the prince became tired and wanted to rest under the shade of a tree. He was getting weaker every day and could not walk long distances. The princess decided to buy some food from a nearby market. When she returned, she saw her husband fast asleep and a snake emerging from an anthill nearby. As she was about to caution, she saw another snake emerging from her husband's mouth. She hid herself to keep a watch. The snake from the anthill said to the other snake, "Why do you torture this handsome prince? You risk your life too. If the prince brings soup of cumin seeds and mustard, you would die for sure." The snake from the prince's mouth said, "Why do you guard two pots of gold, which you do not have any need of? You risk your life too. If someone pours hot water and oil on the anthill, you would die for sure." After a heated argument, they went inside their respective places. But the princess had already known their secrets. She acted accordingly and fed her husband with a soup of cumin seeds and mustard. Within hours, the young prince began to recover and regained much strength. After that, they poured hot water and oil on the anthill and dug out the two pots of the gold that the snake was guarding. Now that the young prince had started recovering and they had two pots full of gold, they lived happily ever. So the moral of the story is, when your enemies quarrel, you are the winner.
So friends, after listening to this story, Owl King Arimardhan accepted his advice that Sthirjeevi's life should be spared. Raktaksha, the first minister, was sad and told the ministers, "You have misled the king by giving wrong advice and paved the way for his destruction." The learned have said that where wicked men are honored and wise men are insulted, there will be fear, famine and death. Disregarding the warning of Raktaksha, the king's men set out to take Sthirjeevi to their fortress. On the way, Sthirjeevi said, "My lord, in my condition, I cannot be of any help to you. Why do you unnecessarily carry me to the fortress? I will jump into a fire and perish. Please permit me to do that. Sensing his internal thoughts, Raktaksha asked him why he would want to end up in fire. Sthirjeevi said, It is for your cause I met this fate in the hands of Meghavarna. Raktaksha said, You are a cheat, good at spinning words. You were really born as a crow, and even if you are born as an owl in your next birth, you will still be a crow in nature. Haven't you heard the story of the mouse, which even when she was born as a girl in another birth, chose to marry not a human being, but another male mouse? The ministers and other king's men forced Raktaksha to tell them that story. Raktaksha then told the story of mouse maid made mouse. So friends, we will bring the story of mouse maid made mouse very soon. Do write your views about the story of two snakes in the comment section. If you like this podcast, then click the like button and also share it. See you soon in the next story. Stay tuned with this series for listening to more Panchatantra stories. Take care. Bye.